All right, guys, we are moving on to practice test number two. So when you log in to CLTexam.com, you should have your account already set up. And if your profile completion says only 15%, then you need to go in and finish that before you show up for your test on a Saturday at school. We don't want to be the one that's slowing down progress for everybody else when it's time to start the test. So make sure your profile is complete. If yours looks like this, take some time to do that now. And we're going to take practice test number two. So right from your dashboard, as soon as you log in, you just come here to take test number two and start test. And I'm going to skip all the way down to the math section, which is called quantitative reasoning on CLT. And that's where you find it. And this is where I want you to follow along while we go through these math questions together. Make sure you have some paper and a pencil or a marker board and a marker, something to write on to do the math while I walk through the steps with you. I'm going to switch over to my PDF because I can write on this. I can't write here in the test. I like having this up though because I can see the formulas anywhere I'm at in the test. If I'm down here at question 95 and I want to look at the formulas, I can just click the button here. I don't have to scroll all the way back to the top. Also, this counter on the side lets you know how many questions you have remaining in the test. Since I skipped section one and section two, mine will always say that there's 80 questions left. And right now, while we're starting this test, while you're in here, I want you to do your first job. Your first job when you're taking your test is to get fast at selecting your letter of the day. So on practice test two, I'm gonna select answer choice B for every single question like this. And I want to see, oh gosh, how quickly can I do this? How fast can we go? This ensures that while you're taking your CLT exam, you do not leave any questions blank and you don't get into panic mode at the end and just start selecting random letters. Any questions that you guess on, you want to stick to one answer choice. And for me on test number two, I'm picking B. So look how fast this is. I'm already up to number 111 and at number 120, we're done. Oops, did I skip one? Nope. B, B, B. B, B, B. When we're in class, I call this see your way through the test. So now there's only 80 blank questions, and I've picked B for everything, and I am ready now to start looking at the questions, which I'm going to look at over here instead. Question number 81 on practice test number two. A biologist is studying a population of chimpanzees in a wildlife preserve. There are 16 chimpanzees in the population, comprised of 7 male chimpanzees and 9 female chimpanzees. One day, 6 male chimpanzees are taken for routine veterinary procedures. If the biologist were to select one of the remaining chimpanzees at random, what is the percent chance that the chimpanzee would be female? So that's our question. What's the percent chance that the chimpanzee would be female out of the remaining chimpanzees that day? So there are how many females? Nine. And I'm going to set this up like as a fraction. I want to know the females. My bar here is telling me out of how many total chimpanzees. And when we look, it says there are 16 chimpanzees, but six male chimpanzees were taken out for the vet. So we're taking away six. So we got 9 out of 10 chimpanzees. Anytime we're taking a fraction and turning it to a percent, we put our fraction over 100, and then our numerator is our percent. So that's 90%. Number 82. This is the question that got me when I first did the practice test. I missed this one when I was rushing through. If I hadn't been rushing, or if I had done some practice before jumping into the test, maybe I wouldn't have missed what was going on here. A mother buys two types of shirts for her son, red shirts and blue shirts. Before she goes shopping, the ratio of red to blue, the ratio of red to blue in the son's closet is 11 to 14. She buys two new red shirts and four new blue shirts. When she adds these to her son's closet, what's the new ratio of red to blue shirts? Well, the ratio is 11 to 14, but we don't know if the son has 11 red and 14 blue shirts. If he does, then we would just add two and add four, and we'd get answer choice C, 13 to 18. But it's only the ratio is this. So it could be that her son is really into shirts and he's got double that. What if he's got 22 red shirts and he's got 28 blue shirts? And if mom goes shopping and buys two new red shirts and four new blue shirts, then when we simplify this ratio, it does not equal to C. So for us, actually, this is impossible to figure out without a little bit more information. So they kind of got me on this one. But now that you're doing your practice before you take your real test, I think you'll be spared my fate of missing this type of question. All right, number 83. How many numbers? Let's do it for the purple and gold. Here we go. Look at that, purple and gold. How many numbers between 1 and 100 inclusive meet both of the conditions given in the statements below? The number has factors of 5 and 10, and the number is divisible by 4. So the number has factors of 5 and 10. So when you're making the factor tree, like out of, I don't know, 80, right? You could say, oh, that's divisible by 10 and 8. And you could also say that's divisible by 2 and 5. So 10 and 5 are underneath that number in the factor because they're factors. So that means that 80 has to be a multiple of both of those numbers. And our multiples of 5 and 10, we know that all the multiples of 5 are included in the multiples of 10, right? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. All of the multiples of 10 are in there. So I'm not even going to worry about the multiples of 5. And I'm going to go straight to my multiples of 10. So between 1 and 100. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. And then I'm going to see which of those numbers satisfy statement number two. The number is divisible by 4. I know 4, 8, 12, you're out. 4 times 5 is 20. 24, 28, 32, out. We didn't say 30. Times 10. And I already see a pattern. All of the numbers that start with an even number are in the pattern, and all the numbers that start with an odd number are out of the pattern. So there's 5 numbers that satisfy both statement 1 and statement 2. So we can move on. Number 84, what are the solutions of the equation 0 equals 3x squared plus 2x minus 8? There's 2 ways we could go with solving this question. You could factor this out into something times something. And when you do that, one of them is going to be a fraction. And I don't really want to do that. Because when I'm looking at my answer choices, I can see that there's a whole number. And every one of those whole numbers is different. So for me, I'm not even going to look at the fractions. I'm only looking at the whole numbers. And I'm going to real fast take my my equation, 0 equals 3x squared plus 2x minus 8. And I'm going to take out my x and I'm going to put in those whole numbers. So goodbye x. And hello, let's try 2. 2 squared is 4, times 3 is 12, plus 2 times 2 is 4, minus 8. 12 plus 4, 16 minus 8 is not 0, so that's not the answer. And then answer choice B has a negative 2. Negative 2 squared, still 4, times 3 is still 12. But 2 times negative 2 is negative 4 minus 8. 12 minus 4 is 8 minus 8 does equal to 0. So we have found our answer without having to mess with fractions. Yay! And I'm going to end this one here, and we'll pick up on number 85 on the next video.